Hello, welcome back to my next video. And in this particular video, we will be discussing about the protein preparation using AutoDocVina. Okay, so first, for that, you have to just go on your desktop where the AutoDocVina icon is available with respect to MGL tools. So you will also get the path for the same. And if you want to get towards the path, you can just simply go, okay. That is the program files, and you will get the folder. Okay, so in this particular folder, you will get the three different files which contain with respect to the Vina, and then you will get the license for the Vina and the script file for the Vina. Okay, so like this, three different files you will get from here. But what you have to do, you have to go to your desktop and you have to just simply click on the icon of AutoDocVina, and you will get the particular AutoDocVina to be get reopened in your system. Okay, so this is nothing but the tool of AutoDocVina. So right now we are going to perform the protein preparation. So for protein preparation, you have to get the protein in the form of PDB file format. Okay, so once you do that, you can simply drag the particular PDB file in this particular tool, or you can simply go towards the file and go towards the read molecule. Okay, once you do that, it will ask you the PDB file. So if you have a PDB file, you can open, or else you can simply download from the RCSP PDB database. Okay. So this is nothing my PDB file. Okay. Now we are going to perform this step of protein preparation using AutoDocVina. So protein preparation is the most important thing before performing the molecular docking. Okay. So what are the steps in protein preparation we are going to see right now? So you have to go towards the edit. Okay. And then you have to go towards the delete. Okay. You have to delete the particular water molecules. For that, you have to go towards the delete water. Okay, once you do that, you will see this thing. Okay, so the water molecule has been removed. So why we have to remove the water molecule? Because when you are performing the molecular docking ahead with respect to drug or the ligand, so in the pocket region, wherever the hydrogen bonds are there, so it will try to interact with the work ligand. So to avoid that, we have to remove the water molecule. Okay, next, the step, you have to go again towards the edit, and you have to go towards the hydrogen. Okay, and you have to click on add hydrogens. Okay, so you have to click, and that it's nothing but the add polar hydrogens. Okay, so I'm going to click on okay. So it is done, polar hydrogens has been added. And again, you have to go to edit. Okay. So in edit, once you go back in edit, you have to go towards the charts. So in charge, you have to go towards the first, that is add Coleman charges. So that is widely being used. So you have to use this. Okay. Again, once you do the edit and the charges, you have to click on add column charges, and you have to simply click on okay. Okay, and you have to, now the last step we have to perform is simply save this. So you have to go towards the particular, here you can again get how many chains are there with my particular PDB file. So you have to go towards the save. Okay. And here you can just see that save the PDB QT. Okay, you can simply define the particular path. Okay, and you have to click on OK. So this particular file can be get saved in the PDB QT. Okay, so next we are going to see how to proceed ahead for respect to the ligand preparation. Thank you.